Good morning, everybody. Please be seated. This morning we've got a different sort of service. We've got people from the Basics charity, Liz and Becky, with us this morning, and they're going to be taking part in the service later on. And we will hopefully learn more about baby basics, and what we've got in front there is, they'll tell you more about it, but it's the sorts of things that they give to new parents, mothers. So we come to worship this morning. Even though the evil adversary prowls around looking for someone to devour, we come together under the protection of God, who resides at the center of our beings. And we're going to stand and sing our first song, Stand Up and Bless the Lord. Becky and Lisa come from Grange Park, is where actually Grange Park Church is where they worship. And interestingly, just speaking before the service, and they told me that it's an ecumenical partnership, Grange Park. So, which leads into the next bit of our service. It's 7 years since the Methodists started worshiping with us, while they were hoping that their building would be sorted out. We would be closer together. But on the 7th anniversary, Trevor's going to come and renew our covenant.
As Adrian said, 7 years ago, on the second Sunday in February 2016, Kingsthorpe Baptist Church and Kingsthorpe Methodist Church first met for regular worship together here. On the second Sunday in February 3 years ago, a formal partnership agreement was arranged, and it was signed by representatives of each church. Within that written agreement, it states that the second Sunday in February will be considered as the anniversary of the partnership, and it further states that it is hoped that this occasion will be celebrated with a prayer during the service. So in a moment I shall lead us in prayer, prayer continued, joint commitment. Over the past few months, the joint leadership team at Kingsthorpe and Northampton Methodist Church Council have been looking at this agreement and has made a number of updates. This has mainly been brought about by the change in structure of the Methodist Church in Northampton. And now the agreement is between Kingsthorpe Baptist Church and Northampton Methodist Church at Kingsthorpe. We've also taken the opportunity to update some minor clauses in the agreement. However, it should be noted that the decision that we made 2 weeks ago to work to becoming a single Christian fellowship does not alter anything in the agreement as it presently stands. If any of you wish to read the details of the agreement, then there's a number of copies on the table at the back. Please take one if you wish to. Alternatively, if you speak to me after the service, then I will email you a copy so you've got an electronic copy. So let us all now enter into prayer. Creating and redeeming God, we give you thanks and praise. We come this day to reaffirm the partnership made between Kingsthorpe Baptist Church and Northampton Methodist Church at Kingsthorpe. We promise to watch over all of our friends and companions as we walk together before you, in ways that are known to us, and also as we walk into the unknown, wherever that may lead us together. In our congregation, we commit all that we have and are to fulfil God's purpose of love. Pour your Spirit upon us. Help us to walk in your ways, that the life that we live together may become an offering of love, truly glorifying you. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you.
We're now going to sit and listen to a YouTube song message about the Old Testament covenant, reminding us of what covenants in Christian communities are. Becky, who's going to, sorry, Lisa. Going to hand over to Lisa. She's got a clicker here. If you, that's the one to advance, and that one's to go back. So we learn about baby basics.
Thank you. Can you all hear me okay?
Yes.
Lovely. So my name's Lisa Smith. I'm one of the trustees of Baby Basics Northampton. And as Adrian said, I worship at Grange Park Church, Northampton. And I'm joined by a fellow trustee and treasurer of Baby Basics, Becky White, who also is a member of Grange Park Church. And we're so delighted to be able to be with you today. So thank you very, very much for inviting us. I know that many of you already know of the work of Baby Basics and have been collecting for us. And for that, we are truly grateful because the charity is totally dependent on the donations of people's kindness. And so we really, really appreciate that. But we are going to tell you a little more about it. Just wanted to comment on the song that we've just heard. I've never heard that before, and it's really beautiful, isn't it? And there was the line in it there about keeping us forever safe in his grace. And that's really key to what we're here to talk about today, because Baby Basics is, we totally believe that every baby given to us is a gift from God. I actually became my stepson's wife had a baby day before yesterday, so again became a grandmother again, and that joy that you get when a new baby comes into the world is just so precious. And we really believe that that joy should be, people should be able to just enjoy their new baby and know that they can keep their new baby safe and secure with everything that they need. But there are so many mums who aren't in that position for various reasons. Maybe it's poverty, maybe they're not able to afford what they need. Maybe they've escaped from a domestic abuse situation. Maybe they've been trafficked into this country. There are all sorts of reasons why some mums feel that they're not in that position to give their baby all that they need for that safety and that comfort and that provision in those first weeks of life. And that's where Baby Basics comes in. We're not, Baby Basics Northampton is not the origin of Baby Basics. The origin was in Sheffield. In 2009, the lead midwife in Sheffield was the lead midwife for displaced groups, people who were in those challenging situations. And she felt she couldn't meet that need. And so she approached the church, and that's where it started from. And what then happened was that she, after having run that for 3 to 4 years, she went out and talked to Christian conferences around the country, saying, do people want to do this in other parts of the world, in other parts of the country? And I was at the New Wine Conference with another lady from Grange Park Church, Angie Kennedy. And at that point, so 10 years ago, this lady spoke and Angie said, we need to do that in Northampton. And that's where we started. And we started with a team of volunteers from Grange Park Church, just a few people, as their outreach from the church, doing this in their garages, a little tiny group of volunteers. And we've grown into an actual charity, a registered charity. Sorry, I'm flicking too quickly. A registered charity. We have premises in Wollaston. We employ 3 staff. And we have, this is our premises in Wollaston. You can see that we've got all this operation going on where there's all the boxes containing, you know, here's one with all the nappies, here's one with all the baby clothes. And what we do is, as you've seen at the front here, we prepare a Moses basket or a baby bath, whatever the need, wherever the need is greatest, and we fill it with everything both the baby needs and the mum. So toiletries for the mum, even chocolates for the mum, things that are needed for those first few weeks. And we partner with the health service, with all of the midwives and the health visitors. We also partner with social services and with women's refuges, so that when they highlight a need, we prepare the starter pack and then we arrange for it to be transported out to them. We are celebrating 2 milestones this month. or last month. So the first one is that Baby Basics Northampton has been going for 10 years. It's our 10-year anniversary. And the second one is that we delivered our 2,000th pack, starter pack. So that's 2,000 babies given a safe place to sleep and all that they need. We managed to continue all through the lockdowns to continually meet every referral that was sent to us. It was considered an essential user service, and so we were able to carry on with our best staff team. We weren't able to keep our volunteers on at that time, and we weren't able to keep our donation points open, so we were very much dependent on financial donations at that point to be able to purchase what we needed and keep going. But we met every need that came in. And in a moment, I'm going to hand over to Becky, but I just wanted to say we are entirely dependent on the goodwill of people like yourselves. That's how Baby Basics is formed. And we'll talk a little later about how you can support us in other ways, volunteering and so on. But we're going to just explore, as we go through the service, we're going to explore the why. Why do we do this? What is it that inspires us from a Bible perspective? And what we really believe is what God is calling in this work. So I'll hand over to Becky now.
Thank you. Well, thank you, Lisa. Hi. So one of the important driving forces for our charity is that we believe that every baby should have a safe place to sleep. And when we think about mothers who had nowhere to lay their baby, as Christians, we can relate this to the birth of Jesus and the mother of Mary. Oh, sorry, I read that wrong, Mary. I'd like you to use your imagination now, if you can. You can close your eyes if that helps. I'd like you to imagine you are Mary. You have traveled to Bethlehem, heavily pregnant. How might you be feeling? Tired? Happy? Excited for the new arrival? A bit apprehensive, maybe? I'm sure these are similar emotions to that mothers have today. Now, add in the fact that the baby is going to be born in a stable. Mary struggled to find a safe place to lay her baby, so she laid him in a manger in an animal's stable. Now let's bring things forward a couple of thousand years and think about how some of the mums and dads-to-be are feeling in Northamptonshire. Families with financial hardship, with increases in the cost of living, women suffering from domestic abuse and teenage pregnancies. How might they be feeling now? Worried? In despair? Unable to see a bright future? Now, imagine your midwife brings you a Baby Basics starter pack, a basket for your baby to have a safe place to sleep, overflowing with clothes, nappies, towels, everything your baby will need for the first 3 months of their life, with toiletries for you, all lovingly packaged. It even includes a box of chocolates. Now, how do you feel? Relief? Valued? Loved? A sense of hope for the future? You can open your eyes now if you close them. Mary put her trust and hope in God. She had the knowledge that her baby was the Son of God and had faith that she would be protected and have their needs provided for. We at Baby Basics would like to give that hope to new mums in Northamptonshire, making sure that no mother is in the position of having nowhere for her baby to sleep. We've now got a short video. Are you going to introduce that? Or? Yeah.
So Adrian's going to play a short video now. The words that you hear are from a letter from a mum who wrote to Baby Basics, but it's read out by a member of our team.
You won't know it, but you guys helped me when I had my first baby. He arrived 9 weeks premature. We were already down on our luck, had lost our home, and were staying with my mum temporarily when he arrived. I literally had nothing for him. When my health visitor arrived for her first visit, he had no clothes or nappies that fitted. I never imagined I'd ever bring a baby into the world under these circumstances. I felt like I didn't deserve such a precious little thing because I couldn't even provide the basics for him. I broke down to the health visitor and asked her to take him away and give him to a family who could give him the life he deserved. She refused, and the following day knocked at my door and filled the living room with everything. Everything and more that we could have ever hoped for, that our baby would need for the next few months, with some bits for ourselves also. The relief I felt was indescribable. You gave me the ability to start enjoying my son instead of struggling every second of the day and night with the unbearable guilt that I couldn't provide for him. No thank you will ever be enough, nor a donation, but I do hope that by continuing to donate my first and now my second baby's belongings, that it will help another parent carer feel the relief I felt, and that they too can start enjoying their child and their children like I do. I couldn't have done it without you.
We're now going to sing again, number 14. All Things Right and Beautiful. Number 14, if you've got the book.
All things wise and wonderful, the Lord.
Our first reading is taken from Matthew 25, verses 35 to 40. For I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. I needed clothes, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you looked after me. I was in prison, and you came to visit me. Then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you a stranger and invite you in, or needing clothes and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison and go to visit you? The king will reply, truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The passage that we've just heard is the inspiring passage of Baby Basics. Not just Baby Basics Northampton, but Baby Basics when it was formed in Sheffield. The passion that the people had there and that we have today is around blessing Jesus by blessing these mums and doing his work for these people who have nothing. And today, what we wanted to do, I don't know how much you're used to doing this sort of thing as a church, but we wanted to engage you in the topic. So hopefully everybody's got someone sitting close by them. And we just wanted to ask you some questions, ask you to discuss amongst yourselves and maybe give us some feedback. And the first question is, what did Jesus mean by the line, truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me. So if you just want to discuss amongst yourselves for a moment. Okay, would anybody like to share back what's been discussed? Anyone want to give us any ideas? God wants us to give and keep on giving. Thank you. Yes?
We just recognise that we are Jesus' hands and our pockets are filled with his blessings, so it's our duty to just pass that on.
Oh, how beautiful. So I don't know whether everyone heard that, but saying that we are Jesus' hands and our pockets are filled with his blessing that we can pass on using our hands. That's beautiful. Anything else that anyone wanted to share?
Something here at the back said, we don't want to wait till we see God in heaven. We want to see him now, and we want to do things for him now.
Oh, that's beautiful. Yes, that's kingdom life right here, right now, isn't it? Rather than the kingdom of heaven being a faraway place, it's God's kingdom coming right now when we do that. Beautiful, thank you. Yes. Oh, sorry. Oh, yes. Yes, he gave us his love, and we give that love unto others. Thank you. And sorry, there was one in front here.
And then to keep on giving, even when things aren't in the spotlight or on TV anymore.
Yes,
to
yes.
Keep remembering.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you so much for sharing that. That's a real personal experience, and I'm just so pleased that the church did encourage you in that. And that's who, you know, we are called to do that, and Baby Basics is a key part of that. So thank you for that. So second question would be, when Jesus said, the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, who is he referring to? Who are the least of these brothers and sisters of mine in our context today? You know, thinking about that today in 2023, who are the least of these brothers and sisters of mine? Do you want to just have a little chat amongst yourselves on that one? Okay, would anybody like to share back?
It's
anyone who's in need. Yes, thank you. Any other thoughts? Yes. The least resources, yeah. Yes, yeah. Any other thoughts on it?
I don't think that poetry says that any of us least loves the brothers and sisters until she doesn't have to be loved.
That's beautiful. Yes, we are none of us, you know, it doesn't see any of us as the least. We are all his brothers and sisters, and we just shine his love through us. And it's the upside down kingdom that we hear about, isn't it? That, you know, when Jesus says that the least will be most and the most will be least, you know, what we think of in this world as sort of people who are successful or in a position where they, you know, maybe they're wealthy, maybe they're powerful, maybe they're successful. That's not what Jesus sees as the most. What he sees is that heart, and that whenever we're reaching out to anyone of his brothers and sisters, we are giving his love. I've felt really drawn lately. My daughter has just started university back in September Nottingham. And so she's spending more time in the town centre, walking around the town centre, and she's been enormously struck by the number of homeless people there. And she just keeps wanting to do something about it. So she's,
you know, talking to me about, well, could we have a baking day, Mum, and just go and take cakes around to all of the homeless people? And she said, you know, when I'm going into Tesco's, I'm buying a sandwich for them and that sort of thing. And I think it's that, it's noticing the need, isn't it? And then saying, I'm not going to ignore that need. I'm going to do something about it. Because as the group at the back there said, we are Jesus's hands and feet on the earth, and giving love, giving our love to those people is giving his love. And equally, it's blessing him. It's blessing him as well as those people, where he says, you did this for me. So that's what inspires us at Baby Basics. That's why we do it. We have this really strong belief that Jesus is calling us to bless those mums in need, to prevent, like you heard on that video, the mum saying she felt that she needed her baby to be taken away because she didn't think she could provide. No mum should ever be in that position where she feels that she has to give up her baby. And so give, even just, it seems, shall I switch one off? I think I've got two microphones. I had what, none, and then got two at the same time. But yes, I think it feels like a small thing to be given this basket of provision, and it doesn't feel like it would have as significant an impact as it does, but it does keep mums and babies together because it gives them the confidence that I can do this, and it's a sign of Jesus's love for them and for their baby. So that's why we do it. And when you are giving your gifts to Baby Basics, you are being Jesus's hands and feet on the earth. You are blessing him. And so my final question isn't for discussion. This one's just for a moment of reflection. We'll just have 1 to 2 moments of reflection. Is to say, what does this passage mean for me personally today? What's Jesus challenging me personally to do as a result of this passage? So I'll just leave that one with you for a moment, and then Becky will come up and lead us in some intercession prayers. Thank you. Thank you for engaging in the conversation. Shall we pray? Father God, we come to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Your word tells us that we are to be as one. We pray that our church family will grow spiritually, that we will study your word and apply it to our lives. We pray that your church will develop a relationship with you through prayer and worship. Help us to become mature Christians, attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ, in Jesus' name. God of mercy, we pray for the people of Turkey and Syria following recent earthquakes. We mourn the death and destruction and pray for those who have died and those who grieve. We hold in our hearts those who are injured and those who have lost loved ones, livelihoods and homes. Lord, bring comfort, strength and renewed hope. Sustain and guide all responding to the disaster. Grant those affected courage and resilience as they build their lives and communities. Inspire us to unite in solidarity and generosity so that help may reach all those who need it. Loving God, we pray for the people of Ukraine, for all those suffering or afraid, that you will be close to them and protect them. We pray for the world leaders for compassion, strength and wisdom to guide their choices. We pray for the world that in this moment of crisis, we may reach out in solidarity to our brothers and sisters in need. May we walk in your ways so that the peace and justice become a reality for the people of Ukraine and for all the world. In Jesus' name. Lord, we lift our loved ones to you. You love them all. Before the creation of the world, they were engraved on your heart. Ignite them with the holy passion and fire that cannot be quenched. Draw them to yourself with an everlasting love and hope that cannot be shaken. May the light of your truth illuminate their path and bring them to the saving knowledge of your Son. Heavenly Father, giver of life and health, comfort and relieve your children who are sick, that they may be strengthened in their weakness and have confidence in your loving care. Bless all those you have sent to care for your children. May they care with compassion and loving kindness through Jesus Christ our Lord. Lord, the God of righteousness and truth, grant to our King and his government and all in positions of responsibility the guidance of your Spirit. We pray for integrity, truth, and compassion throughout government. We pray for the positive influence of God's people for the good of all throughout government. Your word tells us, first of all, that petitions, prayers, intercession and thanksgiving be made for all people, for kings and all those in authority, that we may live peaceful and quiet lives in all godliness and holiness, in Jesus' name. We bring Nicola Bully and her family in our prayers through this difficult time. We ask that in God's great loving kindness, they might know God's sustaining presence amidst their pain. We pray for those who are stretched beyond their capacity to cope and remain hopeful, that in the challenges of these moments, God will bring a deep sense of comfort, strength and peace, in Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, your infant son was born in a stable, then fled into exile with his parents, faced with an uncertain future, yet he was sent by you as a gift of love to share with the world, a gift carried forward by Baby Basics today. We give thanks for everyone involved in Baby Basics, for the work they do, for the care and support they give, and the generosity shown by so many who support their endeavours, for the staff, their volunteers, and the network of professionals who refer to the charity. And most importantly, we pray for those who need the service, the babies, mums, and families. We ask your blessings on them and their children as they grow, and pray that seeing your love in action, boys and girls, men and women will come to know you personally as Saviour and Friend. Lord, in your mercy, hear and bless and answer our prayers. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Becky and Lisa. We're going to sing another song now about the heart of worship. And just before we do, just want to say that we often think about worship being what we do in church on a Sunday morning. But actually, what Becky and Lisa do, the distribution of the Baby Basic gifts, when we look out for others, when we share God's love with others, that is all worship. Worship is what we do every day, not just what we do on a Sunday. And I'm going to stand and sing along with the video, The Heart of Worship by Matt Redner.
When the music fades, all is stripped away, and I simply come, longing just to bring something that's of worth, that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear, you're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made it, when it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. King of endless worth, no one could express how much you deserve. Though I'm weak and poor, every single breath, I'll bring you more than is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear. You're looking into my
lovely song to reflect on, isn't it? The second Bible reading is a short verse taken from Genesis 12, verse 2. I will make you into a great nation, and I will bless you. I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing. God is a blessing to us so that we can pass this blessing on to others. I thought we could take a few minutes just to say a blessing over each other, either together with a person sitting next to you, or just quietly by yourself. But I'd like to encourage you to take this time to actively encourage each other. There are a couple of examples on the slide. Next slide. There we go. Just take a few moments just to say a blessing over each other. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Before we finish our time with you today, I'd like to just let you know some of the ways that you can be a blessing to Baby Basics. Firstly, I'd like, if you're on the internet, I'd like you to encourage you to use our Facebook page, Baby Basics Northampton. You'll see a logo. We have a pink chick as our logo and a blue background, which you might have seen on some of the slides. And there we have lots of information about where you can donate items. We have a pop-up shop in Western Fable, so you can come along and chat to us, and sometimes in the town centre. And you can come and volunteer on site if you're able, or in your own home. We have volunteers that wash all the baby clothes, so they all smell lovely like fairy. We've got some leaflets down here as well that tell you all the information as well. So come and grab one of those afterwards, or come and have a chat to us. That'd be great. If you feel moved to become a trustee as well, we always have a vacancy for an extra pair of hands. So come and speak to us after. Or even our staff team, where in the next few weeks we'll be advertising for a new member of our staff team. So if you fancy a change in career, please keep an eye on our Facebook page. We are also looking on the next slide, I think. At the minute, we carry these big baskets around and collect all the donations and take them to our site in Wollaston and up the stairs and all that sort of thing. And we're realising that that's taken up quite a lot of time. So we are actually looking for a delivery driver to collect and deliver our items, preferably with a big van. And it's just a 6 hours a week contract. If anybody knows of anybody, then please get them to contact us. That'd be great. And as a charity, we welcome fundraisers. So if you fancy a sponsored bungee jump or something slightly less risky, that would be amazing. As Lisa said, we don't get any specific funding from the government, so we rely on personal and corporate donations and grant funders. And you can easily set up a regular personal donation via our local giving page. And they have all gift aid and all that sort of thing on there. If you're part of a company or an organisation or and that can offer us support, that would be great. You can contact us and we'll get the things rolling with that. We'd really love to help another 2,000 babies in Northampton and for another 10 years. So all your support is great. And one of the simplest things you can do is to tell others about our charity. You know, other people that have had babies recently that they might want to donate their baby clothes to a good cause. That's fantastic. And most importantly, please continue to pray for our work. Thank you. Thank you so much for having us here today. Are you doing the next part?
Yes. Over the last few weeks, we have been collecting various things, and I'd like to ask a few people have been sort of do that. We've got some bags at the back, which we're asked now to be brought to the front, and we'd like you to take these as gifts from us, hopefully just part of an ongoing blessing that we can bring to you. We're not going to take them all out of the plastic bags because it would yeah that, but so we thank everybody who has contributed, and if you want to make more contributions, as Becky and Lisa have said, you can do it through Western Favour and that, or you can also bring things into church and we will then make sure that they get to Baby Basics. So just bringing them all to the front there.
Thank you so very much. We really, really value this, and it just means so much. So thank you for your kindness and your love.
Thank you. We're going to conclude by singing a song which I think is very appropriate, because it's "Let the Son of God Enfold You in His Love." And that's what we're really talking about, is us being enfolded in God's love and us enfolding others in God's love. So let us stand and sing to conclude our service. let us go now, determined to turn a deaf ear to the devil's whisperings, and with opened minds and hearts to the Lord's blessing. Let us share the words of the grace together. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all forevermore. Amen. And if you want to come and speak to Becky and Lisa, I'm sure they will be here for a few minutes after the service to speak. Thank you.
Thanks, everybody. You can go on to, you can put the stool. And then it's said, well, there's any threat. I would actually stop sharing. So you can see that.